This is a hastily created documentary about the A4 Pacific. It is a commonly known law of physics that bullets cannot ride on railways. It's far too small, and even if it was the right size, there's no room to fit all the mechanics or the controls or whatever. Or so said the walls of God. However, engine designers have always been one to test the laws of God. One such engineer, Sir Nigel Gresley specifically, after having one too many pints of whiskey scotch, decided to make a bullet train. And, well, this was the result. This thing is literally the prototype bullet train powered by coal and water, spewing out steam everywhere. Anyways, with its fast pace, beautiful streamlining, and I am literally too fast at eye attitude, the A4 Pacifics are perfect for your passenger carrying speed and passenger carrying needs. Did I mention the speed? Oh yes, how about I mention that one more time? One of these engines is actually the fastest steam locomotive in the world, clocked at 126 miles an hour at one time. 126, that is impressive. And can I talk about that streamlining one more time? I mean, good God, it looks spectacular. Again, it looks like a bullet, but it looks great, it's beautiful. I mean, when anyone thinks about grace and elegance, they could usually think of, say, a ballerina performing a dance, or a painter painting his or her Mona Lisa, or perhaps a composer writing his magnum opus. Well, you're wrong. The definition of grace and elegance is this. I'm sure you weren't expecting that, but it's the truth. Unfortunately, one of them was bombed during the Second World War. Which one? This one. Oh God, that does not look good. Farewell, Ralph. You will be missed. Unfortunately, it didn't end there. During the 1950s and the 1960s, the A4 Pacifics were replaced by... Oh God, no. You look like a beluga whale. Or perhaps a sausage. Or maybe someone who spent far too many days at Applebee's eating the St. Louis-style baby back ribs. Do me a favor, Deltic. Next time, eat a salad or an apple. And what happened to the A4s when they were replaced? Well, this happened. Goodbye, Silver Link. Yes, sadly, that wasn't the only engine that was cut up. Several of them. However, six of them have been rescued. Here we have the duck. This was the one that went 126. The bird, or the oldest surviving member of the class. The country, who has a bell on his head. The other country. Not much to say about that, aside from farewell. The person, named after the person who built the engines. And the general, named after Dwight D. Eisenhower. All six of these are currently stalled in museums across the country. Thank heavens for that. So to finish things off, the Gresley Pacifics, the A4s, are some of the most beautiful, graceful, and elegant things known to man. And the only reason we have them is because some chap born in Scotland had far too many voyages to the pub and ordered far too many pints of whiskey scotch. So there. This has been a hastily created documentary about the A4 Pacific.